Hi, in this video I'll talk about how to make your bicycle winterized and so you can ride it in the winter when there is snow, ice and slush and freezing temperatures and so on. It's generally not complicated and many people consider winter to be a bad period to ride bicycles, like it's off season, and I don't think that's the case. At least in my experience, I ride all year long for decades and I enjoy it in the summer and in the winter. For winter cycling, the thing to consider is that there will be a lot of ice and usually a lot of salt. I don't know if every country does that, but in my country they put a lot of salt to prevent water from freezing on the motorways and roads and so on. So if you have an old winter, if you have an old bicycle that you don't mind getting a bit of rust, it's probably a good idea. If you are sensitive to that, you don't want your bicycle to be ruined. But I have a bicycle that is made of steel and I've been riding it since 1996. A few of us in the company passed that bicycle along to each other, but it's been on the road since 1996 and now it's in my home and I still ride it, and that was my dedicated winter hack for many years. And it hasn't rusted through, and there is some surface rust, but I think that's acceptable for decades of abuse. So your bicycle will not melt in the snow, and the rust will, the salt will not really eat it all the way very quickly, but you should pay some attention. First thing to talk about is tires. I have made a video about winter tires, and here I will show for my bicycle that is ridden on flat lands and where the roads are plowed, so there's not like inches of snow, but it's about this at maximum, then it gets plowed. So for that I opted for narrower tires that are better at cutting through the snow. And for the front I have a studded tire, so any ice cannot surprise me, so that I can slip and lose control if the front wheel slips. While for the back wheel I opted for a tire with this model is, let's see, Terra Trail by Continental. It has relatively small knobs. It's not very, it doesn't have very big knobs, but that allows me to ride very quickly and easily on the shallow snow. It doesn't slip as much as some slick tires or tires with no knobs at all, but it also rolls very quickly and nicely on pavement, and it does grip reasonably well on ice. For those that ride in hills, it's better to have a studded tire at the back, but for flatlands, a tire with minimal tread, slicks are better for ice, as I explained in that video about winter tires, but small knobs grip better than big knobs. You just deflate the pressure a bit and it's not too bad. But for the flatlands, if I lose traction of the rear wheel, I can usually recover very quickly. For hills and going up hills and bombing downhill, it's better to have studded tire at the rear. Why I haven't done that is because we have a lot of snow, then it clears in a few days and we have a dry week and then another week of snow. So instead of always swapping wheels or swapping tires, I decided to have just the tire like that on the rear, because the studs do get worn more quickly when you ride them on pavement. They are intended for ice and snow, and they don't grip as well on the they don't grip as well on the pavement. I'll get back to that later, but this is like a universal solution for me that works best, and I opted for 35 millimeter wide tire, both because it cuts through the snow easily if it's shallow and slush, and because I have mud guards. And the original tires on this bicycle, the ones I generally use, are 37 to 40 millimeters wide. And so when I wanted to ride in snowy conditions, I went for a bit narrower tire, because knobs do add a bit of outer diameter, and I wanted to have enough clearance so that no snow or ice or mud gets stuck between the tire and the mud guards to prevent me from being able to ride. So I wanted to increase that clearance a bit. And this bicycle would not be able to accept much wider tires with knobs generally if you ride it in snow or mud. And when it comes to the grip of the studs, Schwalbe Marathon winter tires, as I explained in that video, they have another option that I didn't mention there, and that is if you inflate them to the, their maximum pressure or just below that, the midsection that is just rubber will get in contact with the ground and studs will have minimal contact. Still, if the wheel starts sliding, the studs will come in contact and grip, even though when I know there is snow and ice, I then inflate them to the optimal pressure. But when there's, when it's dry, I just inflate them a bit, like half bar or 5 to 10 psi more than I normally ride, and then I have no problems with studs getting into a lot of contact with the ground, so I get a good grip, but I cannot do any fast cornering or things like that, because then the studs do get in contact, and if you ride on cobblestones or something like that, it can be slippery. So it's a bit of a trade-off. You can't have it all, and in my experience, this is the safest option for me. I can confidently ride in all sorts of conditions, and they don't, the studs don't wear out, and the tire doesn't wear out very quickly when it's on the front. The rear one gets more weight, more load. You pedal with your rear wheel, it's a drive wheel on a bicycle, so there I try to not use studded tire unless I really have to. So that's the first thing, to find the combination of tires that suits you. For any deeper snow, it's better to have a bicycle that can accept wider tires, 2 inches or even more, because those tires don't fall into snow so much, and you can ride them at a lower pressure, so you get a bit more stability and you can roll a bit faster on deeper snow, even though I think that past some 20 centimeters it makes no sense to, even less, even 15 or maybe even 10, it makes no sense to use bicycle for commuting. You can use it for exercise and fun outside, but for commuting it gets very slow and problematic. Maybe those fat bikes solve that problem. I haven't tried riding those in the winter because our roads get plowed and this does the job. However, this is, I'll show it, any sort of fine lubricant is good. This is some made by Motip, like Teflon spray. And it's good idea to generously spray all the pivots and springs of derailleurs and everything. See, this one is not working very well now. It needs a bit of love and care, and brake pivots and everything, because those things will get full of slush and they will start rusting a bit probably if you ride in the snow and those ice, melted snow and salt. That combination does create problems. So again, if you have a old beater bike, it's probably a good idea for snow. But I ride this, this is my daily commuter, I ride it every day all year long and practically every day, and it should serve me, so I don't pay much attention. I give it some regular maintenance and it's bomb proof. A good idea is to have friction shifters that do not click, they just move, and you just move them and they work. So friction shifters are a good idea because they don't have any sensitive mechanism. You can just use it to move the frozen cable by force to clear it, and a bit of WD-40 on the cables, and having perhaps a small package with you on the road can help if you have these sort of derailleurs that are on the outside. For those that ride in very harsh winters, internal gear hubs are, that's one of the uses of them that I find practical. Otherwise I don't like them for some reasons. I'll make a separate video on that, but for deep freezing winter, those hubs are a good idea. And also, if you have mountainous terrain, disc brakes could be a good idea. Rim brakes may not be efficient if you ride in like freezing rain or something, and so those hub brakes like Shimano roller brakes and disc brakes are a good idea for mountains and very harsh winters. But for general use, commuting on cleared roads and for flatlands, I've had no problems with rim brakes, even at minus 15 degrees Celsius temperatures, well below freezing, and with a lot of snow I could stop and they worked. Just do some more, a bit more regular maintenance, and it's generally been good. I've had no problems. So it's not nothing special, and people ride all year long on bicycles as soon as they see it's possible. I had many friends who saw me riding all year long and thought, how do you do it? And when I showed them, it's okay, they started riding too, and it's If you don't have any long distances, it can be a great way for commuting. And also, if you ride for fun, you can take your bicycle out in the winter and ride it. Just use normal common sense, try things out. These are just some basic tips from my experience that I hope will help you, but just go for it. That's all I can say. And that's it. Thank you for watching and cheers. If you like this video, you can click on subscribe and choose this bell option. Select all so you get notified whenever I upload a new video.